Okay, so we have a question, right? What is the forecast unemployment in 2021? Okay, if you go and Google Thai unemployment rate, right, you will see that Thai unemployment rate is very low. It's like 1%. One of the main reasons is that, right, there are a lot of self-employed. There are a lot of people who are doing their own business. They are in the gig economy, G-I-G economy. There are a lot of people who are street store vendors. So actually the unemployment rate in Thailand, right, is something that is quite difficult to measure. They don't have a very good system in creating like for Singapore, we have the Singapore Census that they'll go around doing research. So if you Google Thai unemployment rate, right, actually Thai unemployment rate is very low. In fact, it's lower than Singapore, it's the lowest across like Southeast Asia. If I'm not wrong, World Bank put it at 1% only, or zero. In fact, don't know 1% or 0.1%, which in my opinion, right, is not true. It's not a true reflection of the market. And for developing countries, right, there's always a problem with the underground economy. So the underground economy actually helps a lot of families survive. So like, you know, like if let's say you go around the world, then like unemployment benefit is given to people in the US. But what happens if you are in the underground economy? If you are somebody who is doing something that's not too legal, then how are you going to be deemed unemployed so that you can receive your unemployment benefit? So these are the problems, and this is also a problem that is facing Thailand. But to be frank, right, a lot of our Thai friends who are business owners or even other agencies or even developers or even our own company ourselves, we own a company in Thailand. Okay, our revenues have dropped significantly since the start of COVID-19. There's nothing for me to hide. If you want me to give you an honest snapshot of how we are doing, right, if we are selling well, we'll tell you we are selling well. If we are selling not so well, we'll tell you we're not selling so well. If you ask me, our resale volumes have dropped, our new launch volumes have dropped. Some developers, they are selling still generally quite okay, like Sensiri, right, last month was one of the record quarters for them, but they had to discount heavily on some of their units. And yeah, so those developers that were aggressive, right, of course the agencies can sell, so of course like for us we can sell for them, okay, but it's spread out among so many agencies. Then in the past we can move like double digits every month. We are not expecting that anymore come 2020. And one of the lucky things is that luckily our rental is not too expensive, so we are not we don't expect to be in the red as an agency, and our staff cost is not a lot. That's why a lot of times some people, they ask us why is it that you only serve the people who buy from you. So people who don't buy from us, right, they buy from other agents, and they come to us and say, can you help us get a tenant, or can you help us do resale? Then we don't have the capacity, right, to help you to do that, because we don't have enough manpower. Our agency is only like 6 strong only, so we are not a large agency, so we can't do that. And luckily we're not a large agency, that's why we can survive today. Okay, so if you ask me what's the forecast unemployment in 2021, right, I'm not very sure, but what I can tell you is that businesses and those people who are self-employed, they will definitely be affected by this COVID-19 crisis. And if there is a lockdown moving forward, right, then there's always going to be a problem when that happens. Okay, so during the lockdown, right, a lot of people don't receive any money, and they do make a lot of noise. Okay, so we have Thai friends that they are affected by this lockdown.